Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Tuesday, July 23rd. It's made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. We might have a lingering shower around a bit this morning, but eventually our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says we will dry out and we might even see some peaks of sun today, but rain is expected to return tonight. Full forecast details available on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. Vice President Kamala Harris has secured enough delegates to secure the presidential nomination, sliding in for President Joe Biden. According to an Associated Press survey taken in the aftermath of Biden's decision to drop his bid for re-election, Harris has now gained enough delegates to take that nomination at the upcoming convention. A day after making the unprecedented decision not to seek a second term, Biden called into a campaign event in Delaware for Harris on Monday, saying it was the right time for him to exit the 2024 race. Harris made it clear to staffers she intended to secure the Democratic nomination and continued the campaign. We have expanded coverage this morning at nj1015.com. You can add a recently discovered security breach to the list of problems facing Rite Aid stores in New Jersey. A security breach compromised the personal information of millions who used Rite Aid several years ago. The company discovered a security incident June 6th after somebody impersonated an employee to gain access to certain business systems. The breach was found within 12 hours. The data obtained through the breach involved names, addresses, birth dates, driver's license numbers, and other forms of government issue ID presented by customers who made purchases or attempted purchases from Rite Aid. Delta Airlines still enduring massive delays and cancellations after that huge global software outage days ago. Delta canceled more than 700 flights on Monday, bringing its total since the outage started Friday to more than 5,500 cancellations. More cancellations are at Newark Airport again this morning. Delta's woeful performance is drawing unwanted attention from the federal government. Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg says he expects Delta to issue quick refunds and to pay for hotels and meals for customers who are stranded due to the ongoing cancellations. We are updating the number of cancellations and the flights involved at nj1015.com this morning. A South Jersey man has now been charged with the beheading of a seagull in Wildwood. 29-year-old Franklin Ziegler of Cape May, charged with third-degree animal cruelty. Witnesses say he decapitated a bird at Maury's Pier July 6th. North Wildwood police responded to calls about the incident. Ziegler was initially arrested on a disorderly persons offense. Police are still trying to figure out what caused a massive truck explosion on Route 3 in Clifton Monday morning. The blast obliterated a sound barrier and melted the siding on a nearby house. The front of the tractor trailer burned beyond recognition. Fire first reported about 9 a.m., not far from where Route 3 meets Route 46 in Clifton. The roadway was closed for several hours. It is expected to be open this morning for morning rush. A former Monmouth County police chief is in trouble, now sentenced for trying to cover up his affair at work. Andrew Kudrick, the former police chief of Howell, sentenced on Friday to 2 years probation for lying during an official interview as part of an administrative investigation. The 50-year-old served Howell for nearly 30 years. He admitted he tried to cover up a sexual relationship with a subordinate. He pleaded guilty to obstruction in May. As part of his plea deal, Kudrick cannot hold a public job. An Ocean County man is charged with running down a pedestrian and then leaving the scene of that accident. Gonzalo Jimenez Hernandez was crossing the street in Toms River about 3 p.m. Sunday when he was struck and killed by a Ford F-150 pickup. The Ocean County prosecutor says when police got to the scene, the driver responsible wasn't there. Investigators later found the pickup truck and its owner, John Marone, at a nearby apartment complex. The 68-year-old Seaside Park man charged with causing death while driving with a suspended license and leaving the scene of a fatal crash. Have something to say about our top stories? Leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls, talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Tuesday, July 23rd, made possible by the Bet Parks Casino and Sportsbook app. Have a great day.